I mean, so far, I guess it would have to be writing my book. Yeah, writing my book for sure. The most meaningful thing I've ever done.
And, like, what would you say, like, pivoted your career and, like, made you, like, just shoot on up with, like, everything you done did?
I don't think it's ever been a place that's, like, I just shot up. I've been on social media, Instagram, for 7 years now. So it's just been kind of just being consistent and being patient. Not really, like, focusing too much what other people got going on and just focus on how I can win my way.
Okay. Well,
I appreciate you joining this live.
Mm-hmm.
You have a great night.
You too.
All right, bye.
Bye.
I feel like I'm on FaceTime. Some people are like, okay, bye. I know. I've just been hanging up now because they're answering and they're getting right off. You know, you play the music when they don't get off. All right. I have a good question that can help all the guys and girls out there. All right. Let's add you to the lab. Let's get some music ready, though, just in case.
If you manage a team, you should be using Monday.com. It's a platform to manage any team and any project.
Hello. I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous.
Okay.
What's your
my question
that
is,
boys and girls can both relate to? And
okay. When is it a good time to walk away? Like, how do you know when it's a good time to walk away from, like, a toxic relationship?
Great question. Background. When is a good time to walk away from a toxic relationship? I would say, in my opinion, immediately. Like, I don't really know how else to answer that. I feel like once you see that it's bad for you, and I mean, I think any red flag is a deal breaker. That's just my opinion. So I think when you come to the realization that this is no longer something that is healthy for you and detrimental to your own well-being and your safety, I think you have to do what's best for you, even if it's hard.
So what if that person is, like, super involved in, like, your life and your family and has, like, all those strings attached to you? Is it still, like, easy to walk away?
Oh, baby, cut them strings, baby. Because the thing is people are hesitant to walk away because there's so much time, there's so much history, there's everything invested in this person. And at the end of the day, like, history means nothing if something is toxic. Like, you have to do what's best for you. And a lot of times you have to kind of do the whole no communication.
Okay,
so,
thank you.
Yeah, girl, are you in a toxic situation, or?
I mean,
baby, you need to get some pills out, baby. Cut, baby.
I mean, I guess I am. I just kind of, like, spent a lot of time, like, investing myself in this person, helping them, like, getting them through a bunch of stuff, and they've been there for me. And then I kind of started realizing things, and the person kept lying to me and lying to me. And the only time I was, like, finding out the truth was if I asked other people. And whenever I would confront him, whenever I would confront the person, he would, like, lie to my face. And,
so,
like, the only time
a liar.
I mean, I don't know.
I mean, I think that's a question you have to ask yourself. Pumpkin, why does she want to be the liar? He ain't got the answer.
I mean, I haven't, like, cut him off completely, but I've been, like, distancing myself, trying to, like, softened, like, the blow a little bit.
you try to what?
Like, I'm trying to, like, soften the blow. Like, I don't want to, like, I don't want it to hurt me. I'm trying to preserve, do some, like, self-preservation.
Girl, you gotta do it. You, girl, you're gonna end up hurting yourself by trying.
So,
to
so I should just
yourself.
Do it fast.
You put
just get it over with.
Honey, you gotta put yourself first.
Okay.
That's my car.
But don't play.
That's my car.
Okay, thank you.
Okay.
Okay.
Bitch, you can DM me. And end it.
Okay.
Alright, thank you.
Don't worry, you're gonna get that car someday, Richie.
These toxic men got stuck up.
Alright. 5 in the morning.
Alright. Where's Dylan's at? I don't see him. I got the biggest question of your life. Let's hear it, and then I'll try to find Dylan. Alright. The biggest question of my motherfucking life. I want to hear it.
What's up? What's up? How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good. But yeah, I got a question for you, though.
I might have an answer depending on the question.
I'm saying, what's your biggest aspiration? Like, let's say when it's all said and done, like, what's the main, your pinnacle where you want to reach, like, in general?
I see we're getting all the deep questions on live, but I'm what do I want to, pretty much you're saying, like, how do I want to,
when you retire and you feel like, all right, I did everything I can. Like, this is like my last, like my main goal. Like, I reached like the highest point of my career. Like, what is the highest point you want to reach in life? Then when you leave the earth, they're gonna be like, oh, Brittany, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is, like, you're gonna feel happy. Like, I feel good. Like, you know what I'm saying?
I don't want to give like an underwhelming answer, but my answer is just pretty simple, and it's just, for me, I think my biggest thing with my book and me just speaking on videos is
inspiring people.
No, because it's like inspiring people to do what? Like, you have to ask me, like, people say, oh, I want to inspire to do what? I'm answering your question.
It's, okay.
It's not about, oh, I just want to inspire people.
Okay.
I want people to own their truth, live in their truth, and think for themselves. That's all anyone ever takes to me. That's more than enough.
Okay.
I want people to think for themselves and live in their truth. And if people individually did that and did their inner work outside of social media, this world would be collectively a much more harmonious place than it is. I think it's that simple. So yes, if I have to be a guinea pig and be, you know, talked about a certain way because of my truth, then I will be that example. Because I don't give
a shit. All right. One more question though. I'm an upcoming artist from New York.
Okay.
And I don't. Yeah. So, what advice would you give me, like, to dominate like the social media? Because it's very hard for like a person like me, especially, to try to dominate like. What you like? I don't know what I have to do. Like, I'm not trying to clout chase and this is that. I'm saying, I'm trying to, you know, try to release real content and everything, but it's just hard to build a fan base just being real sometimes. That's why you see a lot of these people try to be like who they not. Like, they just be fake, like, you know, trolling, as they say, and then they become big. So what do you give advice to a real nigga like me? Because, feel me? I'm a real nigga. I'm going to keep it 100. You know what I'm saying? But in a social media, like, being a real person and in the media is two different worlds, you know what I'm saying? So I don't know, like, I try to find like the boundaries. Yeah.
I think you just have to win your way. I mean, I don't think you can worry about how if somebody trolled to get on or somebody did this or if someone did that. I think that's like, it looks like it's dialing. Okay, there it goes. I would just say win your way. I know it sounds simple, but Let's see.
Dylan.
I just added him.
Ma'am.
Hello.
What the fuck is up?
What the fuck is good?
Shut up, tired.
Oh, boy. I don't know. That's good.
No. We cool.
Yikes.
It's been a minute. Don't mind me on that. I've been there since Keep the Haters Mad, September 1st. Brittany Renner experience that I couldn't attend, but you know, I was there in spirit, whatever. Miami, all that shit. So basically, everybody that's in tune with you, what you got the book, BET, all that shit. What's next?
What's next? I think my biggest focus now is ownership, which is different things. I want to write another book. I really would like to make money without a lot of human contact.
You talk about like business ownership wise or just stuff like that? Because like residual income on your back end that you ain't got to, you know, build up on stuff. Both.
Because really, the way I feel to financial freedom is through owning businesses. So it is to me a little harder when you try to do it on your own, but it's just the only way you can really make money and not have to be told what to do, you know? Of course, I would love to act. I want to write another book this year, but I just am kind of just going with the flow and where the passion takes me.
Because like especially with your land, your personality, opportunities present themselves everywhere. It's just a matter of feeling through which ones that you can provide for yourself and a team that can help on you on that too. But I guarantee you, I feel the...
I have a question for you, though, before we switch gears. Are you single?
Yes.
Wow.
I know, right? Shit happened, but yeah, I'm single.
Well, you want to talk about it? Maybe another time.
I mean, I get into it. It don't matter to me if you want, you know.
What happened? Why did you guys break up?
So, first it was a matter of distance, but I was working through that shit. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, I bought a house ready to move her in and all that shit. Like, you know, so I was ready. Because you know me, I'm like, I'm 10 toes down with mine. I don't fuck around, you know. I communicate big and shit. But then at one point, you know, infidelity happened. Right, and I try to talk about it, you know what I'm saying, but nothing set right afterwards, and then she started playing victim, like on me, you know what I'm saying. I'm like, motherfucker, I ain't the one that did that shit to you, you know what I'm saying, because you know me, I'm gonna be like, especially for that situation, I'm like, there's nobody else that exists but that person. You know what I'm saying?
That's just the water sign that you guys watch. Yeah. Dylan is a Cancer, I'm a Pisces, so we kind of understand the whole.
Yeah.
With love, it's just a different level.
Right. You know what I'm saying? And like, because you got a big heart, I got a big heart. And you try to understand somebody so much, like we were talking about in the DMs, whatever. And you just try to communicate yourself so much, and they don't understand what you're trying to do. They want to put it, oh, you overreacting. I'm like, you cheated on me. I'm overreacting. You know what I'm saying?
I'm about to burn this shit down. Right.
I'm purely justified. The fuck is you talking about? So
how are you going to deal with this breakup? Maybe some advice for the viewers out there. How are you going to handle? For those of you who have been cheated on, have cheated, I think you guys should listen up. What's some advice, and what do you think you're going to do?
All right, so for me, you know, I was the type, you know, to hold on to something because I thought what I thought it was and the history behind it. But whenever it gets tainted or tarnished, and you gotta accept within yourself that that's never gonna get back to that if both parties aren't willing to work for that. You know, you can be the most willing person, but if they're doing behavior that's changed on them, you can't just fight for the attention. So within myself, I found out that I allow how people treat me, if that makes sense. Like, you teach people how to treat you. And so with that, you know, she was trying to communicate less, trying to do whatever she wanted and establish all this shit. I'm like, look, you either going to talk to me or you're not. You either want to be with me fully or you don't. And you can't control what anybody else do. So within that of myself, I'm like, I got to do what's best for myself. And if you want to be with it, you with it. And if you're not, then live your life. I wish you peace and happiness, all that, no miss, no blessings. I'm going to continue on doing whatever I got to do, because whatever God got for me, it was that was either that or you was a lesson. So I gotta keep moving. You can't let it. You can't let yourself sit in that folly. You know what I'm saying? With the, you know, you can be depressed. Allow yourself to feel. Never bottle it up. Allow yourself to feel.
Yeah.
If you bottle it up, it manifests into something else, or you take it with you into the next relationship, then you're not hindering yourself. You're hindering yourself. So, off of me, I'm just like I said. Not even a distraction. It's like I acknowledge what it was, I acknowledge what it is, and I move off of that. So now, okay, I'm focused on this job that I got, focus on my music, my investing that I'm doing, you know what I'm saying? So you just gotta manifest and let it be what it is and just continue going forward with it.
Amen, honey.
Yes.
No, you can hit me up, whatever, okay?
Oh, I know. I got one more question. When am I gonna see you again? What the fuck? It's been 2 years.
I don't know, because honestly, I don't do club hostings. I haven't been doing them, I should say.
Right.
I just would like to place my energy elsewhere, so I don't really know for sure.
No.
Yeah, what should we do, Frank?
What's up?
So I'll definitely figure it out soon, and we'll definitely link. So we can have a hard start.
Yeah, oh, yeah, because we need that. We just need, you know, some.
Stay strong, though. You deserve it all, but you have to allow yourself to feel and just feel the hurt and cry. And
yes. Right. And I'm good on it. I'm proud of myself because I definitely see the progress over my past shit. You know what I'm saying? I was like, you either want to be with me or you don't. You're missing your blessing if you're not. So,
hey, honey, you're missing out on a great thing, honey. Go for the realest thing you've ever had, okay?
Never.
You know what I'm saying? All right, love you, Dylan.
Love you.
All right, bye.
Bye.
So we're talking about chefs for you, like.
You're friends with me. Yeah, yeah. Friends with Tenegrass, Chicago. Sean Stewart. Yeah. I think you might be singing soon, but carry on.
Look at us. Foreshadowing. yeah, man. Shit, man. She's been on the hustle forever, as long as I could. I can remember. That's one of the key components of what you shut through. The hustle. And you need to show the right away. Now we're certain.